speaking English. Don't laugh.
Well, where I grew up, which is Nice, France, we had the privilege of having one of the very first great jazz festivals in France. Mingus and Bill Evans, Geddes, and all kind of the great jazz group of the 70s, with guests, with jam session, and I was all completely mesmerized by the fact that you could make music of that level in public, of course, without rehearsing, without anything else. It was a very... The lack of structure made the school to be completely great, because basically it was up to you to find what you could get out of it. Mm. There was no spoon feeding, it was just... So, at first, well, New York is a place. I mean, there's nothing like New York. If you want to study with anyone, you can, you know. And so I came to New York and I did the master's in composition with Bruckmeyer. Mm-hmm. If you don't know the lyrics to a song, there is a dimension of it that you may not be aware of. I think that what's interesting is actually the way you play the harmonies more than changing the harmonies.
The harmony, you added
which
some
is,
stuff.
To me, is,
so
it's
already like
almost
bigger already. Level
exactly.
The harmony, mm-hmm. harmonization. So I guess it's just a level of how far you want to go
exactly.
in the reharmonization.
I do stress that you have to be able to reharmonize.
Yeah.
You have to be able to know how to transform the whole thing. That's an essential aspect of arranging or piano playing. The melody is each time repeated and transformed. Basically, I don't really develop the melody, but I guess I reharmonize it. So F major, and then I go to the sub 5 of B flat minor. So it's B7 to B flat minor, and then up a minor third, and down a minor third. And then I get a 2-5. It's a challenging tune in the sense that there is no real repetition of those six bars. It keeps developing, and it's something that it's important for any improviser to know how to compose. It's not an empty word, and I think that blue note. Something that curiously makes me happy.